The Galaxy S8 2018 is powered by Samsung's own Exynos 7885 chipset. At least that's what benchmarking apps report. Samsung hasn't gone official with such and such, and it's not listed in the spec sheets either. The new chip has a CPU configuration, which we haven't seen before. The processor consists of two powerful A73 cores clocked at up to 2.2 GHz, and six A53s ticking at up to 1.6 GHz. Odd it may be, but we are grateful for the A73 powerful cores as they would make a real difference in regular Android operation. And now, it's benchmark time. Geekbench is what we ran first, and the new processor did fine. A single A73 core is a powerful tool capable of handling anything you throw at it. We are not sure what cores are used for the multi-core calculations, but here the A8 shows an impressive improvement over the Galaxy J7 Pro's A53-based Exynos processor. According to IETA64, the Galaxy A8 2018 has a dual-core Mali G71 MP2 GPU. The previous Exynos 7880 had a dual-core Mali T830 GPU, which means the Exynos 7885 inside the A8 employs a better GPU core. In fact, the G71 is found inside Kirin 960, Pua IP10, and Exynos 8895, Galaxy S8, but instead of two, there are 8 and 20 computing cores respectively. Anyway, the G71 is more powerful than the TA30, off-screen test, but when we factor the increased resolution, on-screen test, it turns out the A8 performs similarly, or slightly lesser, than the Galaxy A7. 2017. The new Exynos 7885 is a small improvement over the 7880. As the name suggests, the CPU is the most notable upgrade, and the daily Android operations handled by the new A73 cores should see a potential boost if you are coming from a J7 or A7. Sure, there are minor, almost unnoticeable hiccups here and there, but we came to accept those as fine for anything that's not a flagship Android. The GPU may have been refreshed, too, but the pixel count bump ate the extra power, so you will get the same gaming experience as on the A7, and it's not bad at all. Even with two GPU cores, the A8 is perfectly capable of handling all popular titles we've tried. And finally, the chip is built using 14 nanometers process and thus is rather cool. We haven't noticed any major heat dispersion, but if you do, you can always use the game launcher to tweak some settings.